Recently, I was on the Richard Quest show on CNN TV, and I was asked the question that we have the battle of the billionaires. On one hand, we have Mark Zuckerberg saying, don't worry, artificial intelligence will give us new jobs, new industries, create wealth, prosperity. And then we have people like, well, Elon Musk, who says, watch out, they pose an existential threat to humanity. Who knows? Maybe one day they'll put us in zoos and throw peanuts at us and make us dance behind bars like we do with monkeys and with bears. Well, my personal point of view is that both points of view are, in some sense, correct. In the short term, I think Zuckerberg is right. Artificial intelligence will open up whole new vistas. It'll make life more convenient, things will be cheaper, new industries will be created. I personally think the AI industry will be bigger than the automobile industry. In fact, I think the automobile is going to become a robot. You'll talk to your car. You'll argue with your car. Your car will give you the best facts, the best route between point A and point B. The car will be part of the robotics industry. Whole new industries involving the repair, maintenance, servicing of robots, not to mention robots that are software programs that you talk to and make life more convenient. However, let's not be naive. There is a point, a tipping point, at which they could become dangerous and pose an existential threat. And that tipping point is self-awareness. You see, robots are not aware of the fact that they're robots. They're so stupid, they simply carry out what they are instructed to do because they're adding machines. We forget that. Adding machines don't have a will. Adding machines simply do what you program them to do. Now, of course, let's not be naive about this. Eventually, adding machines may be able to compute alternate goals in alternate scenarios when they realize that they are not human. Right now, robots do not know that. However, there is a tipping point at which point they could become dangerous. Now, right now, our most advanced robot has the intelligence of a cockroach, a rather stupid cockroach. However, it's only a matter of time before robots become as smart as a mouse, then as smart as a rat, then a rabbit, then a cat, dog, and eventually as smart as a monkey. Now, monkeys know they are not human. They have a certain amount of self-awareness. Dogs, especially young dogs, are not quite sure. One reason why dogs obey the master is because they think the master is the top dog. And so they'll be confused about whether or not we humans are part of the dog tribe. But monkeys, I think, have no problems with that. They know they're not human. So when robots become as intelligent as monkeys, I think we should put a chip in their brain to shut them off if they begin to have murderous thoughts. When will that happen? I don't know. I suspect it'll happen late in this century, because I think we have decades of experience that have to be that we have to go through and learn before we can pose this particular problem. So in other words, I don't think there's any rush today to deal with killer robots that are going to destroy the human race and take over. But I think we have to keep one eye on the ball, and realize that by the end of this century, when robots do become self-aware, we have to be careful.